Hey everybody, I'm here with the beautiful Pat Grief.
Hi.
And she's the teacher of this establishment. Hi.
Hello.
So how do you feel about being interviewed?
Actually, it's good and bad. Not necessarily bad, but enough weird because you have kids asking you all kinds of questions. So it's like a daily interview. Miss, what about this? Miss, what happens there? So you know, it's a daily interview. It's a little, it's not filmed, but yes.
It's nice. And I mean, I love being around kids, and I bet you do too.
Yes, they are darlings. They when you say kids say the darnest things,
it's true. How did Coco Brainiacs come about?
Well, like I said, I've been teaching in the city for 10 years, and got to San Pedro, and I wanted to do teaching again. I didn't necessarily want to go into a formal classroom, and I had a lot of my friends who said, oh, yeah, I have to go to work. You know, I don't know who's going to take care of my child, or, you know, my kid's home, I have to go to work, I come back, then there's, the idea came about, you know what? I love teaching, it's a passion of mine, and I could do something for tutoring. I could do tutoring after school, and I had my first child, like the second day I opened. And
oh, really?
He's been coming here ever since.
Oh, nice.
So, and along the way, other students, it's been a word of mouth thing, you know, a word of mouth recommendation, so that has been good.
I see. So how did you come up with the name Coco Brainiacs? That's pretty clever. I like the name. It's catchy.
You know, the name I had, I was like brainstorming for it. I wanted something that was powerful, Einstein, something like that, but something that wouldn't intimidate kids, but fun and help them to, oh, you know, I'm smart. And Miguel, rest his soul, came up with the name. Miguel.
Good friend. Yeah.
You know, he came up, he's like, what do you think about Coco Brainiacs and the kids sitting under the tree and, you know, reading their books by the beach?
That's awesome.
Like, that is perfect.
What inspired you to create a tutoring center, especially here in San Pedro?
This is a tourist-based industry, meaning that parents that work are going to be on all different hours. You know, shifts. You know, restaurants close 9, 10, 11 o'clock. They have to go in at 5 or have to go in earlier. By the time they're going, their children are leaving school and they're leaving work. So it's like, hi, mom. Bye, mom.
Yeah, I know.
You know, they're 1 past 1. And, I said, you know what, this is something that could make sense. I can have my own schedule, you know. I was never one to conform to the rigid classroom setting, so having my own ideas, you know, manifested, being able to just, this is my idea, and I go with it with a teaching method or something like that, and to see work in an unconventional way, you know, I was like, yes, why not? You know,
that's excellent. I have to thank you for that because, I mean, like you said, there's some students that just get home and are like, hi, bye, mom.
Exactly.
Hi, bye, dad. Mm-hmm. And they don't have time for anything to study with their students. Which is sad, but I mean, that's why Coco Brainiacs comes
along. Exactly. Exactly. You know, we have parents that, and my first child, like, and it was his mom, like I said, she works in the restaurant industry. She's going out at 3 and then they're coming home at 3:30. So they don't really see each other except in the morning when she's kind of groggy getting up. And so when she knows when her child leaves here, his studies is completed, all his homework are done, his test preparation, if need be, is completed. And also, let's say he had a project to do, that project is completed. You have times where the parents will opt to do the projects with the child because, you know, that is their little time. So, you know, all power to them. But when the child leaves here, the parents are satisfied that I don't have to worry about, not necessarily that they're avoiding it, but, you know, they have to work.
Exactly.
You know, so just
to make a living and to keep them in school.
Exactly.
What students do you have in here from what schools?
I have had students.
Because I know this island has a lot of schools.
I know, I was so
a whole lot of schools.
I was going around, so when I first opened, giving out flyers, I could not believe how many private schools I have in this island.
Yeah.
I was shocked. But I have had students from pretty much every student on the island.
That's good.
From every school on the island. So my current enrollment did, I have students from ACES. I have students from Island Academy, from the RC School, Isla Bonita, and I'm pretty cool, and also from the high school.
Oh, that's nice. Mm-hmm. So what's the age range that you have in here?
My qualifications is from kindergarten to high school. And so all my students are at different ages, different age range between that. I have some high school students that come in steadily, you know, classes with studying and test preparation, or exam preparation, and also if they have big projects and they need a little creative inspiration or something like that, they come here and they work, and I tell them, you're coming here for assistance with your project. Don't come here and expect that I'm going to do your project.
That's
entirely out of the question. I am a teacher. The teacher in me simply is not going to allow myself to do someone's project.
That makes sense. Or else you're not going to be learning anything.
Exactly.
Okay, so what subjects do you teach in here?
Pretty much everything.
Everything?
Everything that they need assistance with.
Whoa.
Everything. So math, geography,
this is
algebra.
A genius.
I don't know about that.
Creative one. What are the actual qualifications to be able to join Coco Brainiacs?
Just have homework to do. Just have homework.
So if I come in with my books and be like,
yes,
Pat, I have homework to do, so can I please sit down anywhere in here and just like, can you help me?
Pretty much. I mean, as long as you pay the hourly rate, we don't have no problems.
Right.
But yeah, you know, that's what I do. And then I also do, because most of the things that you will see their charters and stuff are made by myself.
Right.
And that is one other thing besides is that I use the establishment for, is that I make charts for classrooms. If a teacher, let's say, may not have that little creative pinch in them, they can say, Pat, you know, I need my classroom. I need my classroom to be circus themed.
Right.
I make all, because the Ministry of Education has a requirement of 13 charts that you must have for your classroom. And I do that, I help them set it up, I tell them where to put it, you know, whichever they need assistance. So that is also another thing that I do. And when, if they're interested in something, I tell them, come and see what I have. This is what I do.
Fantastic. You know? That's great. I mean, you're inspiring kids, teachers, people who don't speak English. She's amazing. Thank you so much, Pat.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
And that's what's up today.